Let's talk about gold nanostars, how we might be able to create them with the laser, and what they might be useful for. What are gold nanostars? I introduced the concept in a previous video, and I said I was going to go into it in more detail in a later video. So I've been investigating gold nanostars. Now, there's not a lot of information on gold nanostars, so I've had to do a lot of speculation with the AI on it and how to create it. And we're going to cover some of that stuff today. Now, gold nanostars are irregular-shaped nanoparticles. Now, normally, when we create a nanoparticle, it's most likely going to be spherical-shaped. Some nanoparticles, like silver, could be tubular-shaped. And for the most part, when we create a nanoparticle, it's usually spherical, especially when we're doing it with the plasma arc. The plasma arc is like a stamping process. Every nanoparticle is absolutely almost identical to the next one. And I can see this on the laser video microscope. Now, when we move off of plasma arc into creating nanoparticles with the laser, there's a very irregular pattern. And this led me to investigate where this irregular pattern was coming from. Are we creating different size nanoparticles or different shaped nanoparticles? And that led me with lots of discussions with the AI toward nanostars. And it seems it's extremely likely that we create nanostars when we use a laser. And this would explain, when I look at the video microscope pictures of nanoparticles created with the laser, why it looks that way and not like the stamped symmetrical pattern of the plasma arc. And from what I can deduce, we can't create nanostars with the plasma arc without altering the chemistry of the fluid, which we really can't do because then we can't create an arc. But with the laser, we don't care about the conductivity of the solution. We can mess around with it here and there. But what I want to do in this experiment is I want to force the creation of nanostars beyond what we normally might be getting. And I'm theorizing we're getting between 10 and 20% nanostars when we use a laser. Now, gold nanostars are created using gold. But we can have nanostars with any metal. It's just that gold nanostars are like the prodigy child of the medical industry these days because of their unique properties for anti-cancer work and their gold's friendliness to the body. So they're looking into creating gold nanostars for their projects and to carry pharmaceuticals into the body as well. The real core of nanostars, which makes it applicable to us making these nanostars for our health reasons, is that they give off infrared light in the body. And this infrared light is a great deterrent for not only cancer, but also bacteria. And it's a great anti-inflammatory for the body as well. And so gold nanostars has a very healthy property. So let's see if we can create more gold nanostars. That's what I'm doing today. And through investigation with the AI and the research, there are parameters that we need to do in order to make it a better environment for creating these nanostars. And of course, we have to be able to see the nanostars too, and that's something else entirely. Of course, I'm limited with the laser microscope that I have. I don't have a spectrometer, I don't have an electron microscope, so we can't see the actual pattern of the stars, but the AI and I agree that we can pick out these patterns in the reflective light and tell if we're creating more or less nanostars. So let's get into it. First, we need a chaotic environment to create gold nanostars. The laser presents us with that chaotic environment normally. So what we want to do is increase the chaotic quality a little higher. We're going to do that by adding some things to our 50 milliliter of liquid in the Petri dish. First, we're going to add 5 drops of sodium citrate from my stock solution, sodium citrate, which you can look up in the video archive to find out how to make that solution. That's going to prevent the nanoparticles from aggregating. We don't want to lose any of the nanoparticles, and sodium citrate, is small amount of that is still absolutely perfect for drinking. Now we're going to also add already made 20 nanometer silver and gold. Just a small amount, 5 milliliters of each. We're going to seed the mixture with these two things. Silver has been known in some studies to increase the chaotic quality of it, because now we got dissimilar metals in there, and so they're not going to know how to combine in a symmetrical pattern so easily, and they only have a certain amount of time to combine, and they must combine, and the whole idea is to create these things into spiky patterns. Now, adding the gold already in there is because once we have nanoparticles in there, we tend to create nanoparticles a lot faster. So why should we start from scratch? So we're going to add a little gold there. Now, I'm using plasma arc, but I could just as easily have used laser gold for those of you that don't have plasma arc. And I may do another experiment with down the road with using just the laser gold as opposed to the plasma arc gold, but it's just a starting point. And then I'm going to use 14 karat gold, not 24 karat gold. Basically, I don't have a 24 karat gold bar here in the lab. 24 karat gold I have is gold leaf. It's really too thin for the process, and I can't get the proper heat we need and speed we need on the laser using gold leaf. So I'm going to use 14 karat gold, but that's okay because it's 60% gold. It's also got silver in it and some copper and zinc. So why not we create some gold nanostars for those as well? I mean, the test here really is to show the creation of nanostars. Whether we get some gold and some silver and some zinc, well, that's it. That's okay too. There's nothing wrong with that. According to research with the AI and speculation, in laser engraver I have is 18 watts. It's actually more powerful than we need for creating gold nanostars. We need a power of around 30 to 50% of that. Basically, we're looking at under 10 watts of power to create these gold nanostars. So that's good for you guys that have low power lasers. Really, nanoparticles can be created with these low power lasers, even especially if you use the microscope slide trick, which reduces the amount of power that you need on some of the metals so that you can create massive amounts of nanoparticles. So we're not using the microscope trick in this one. I do want to introduce extra unknowns in here. I need the laser power around 10 watts. And figuring out what the wattage actually would be going through this microscope slide is going to increase it, and we don't need that. So for now, no microscope slide for creating the gold nanostars in this experiment. Now, speed is important. Too slow is no good. It will heat the material too much. It will cause not only the loss of nanoparticles, but also the loss of the nanostars. So we need, according to the AI, we need a speed of around 600 to 1,000 millimeters per minute. I'm setting mine for like 750. I'm putting it in the middle range. Not too low, not too high. And then we're going to see what happens. Now, I've already put the machine on, and it's been making nanostars like, hopefully like crazy, so that I can get to the examination part of this process. When it's done, I'm going to grab the sample, throw it in the microscope, and let's do some examination to see the difference between where we started with and where we left with, and comparing it to plasma arcs spherical patterns. Okay, I've examined my findings, and they are really interesting. I'll have to take this one step at a time. Here on my desk are three vials. Each one contains something different. This one here is plasma arc gold at 20 nanometers. This one here is 14 karat gold with the laser, 5 nanometers. And this one here is our doctored up nanostar 14 karat gold. Now we need to examine these things. Now the AI says, the first way to examine for nanostars is using a laser is with your naked eye, believe it or not. And yes, you can take the laser and eyeball it. And you'll go with the laser, you'll put this through the fluid, and you're going to take a look at the consistency of the streams. And it's in the consistency of the streams that's going to reveal possible presence of gold nanostars. The gold nanostars have very pointy tips, and they will reflect the green laser light brightly. We know that colloidal gold, 20 nanometer, has no nanostars in it whatsoever. It's all symmetrical. And when we look at that one, we see a very even pattern. Now, the 14 karat gold made with the laser will create some nanostars just by its own process. So we shouldn't see the same evenly distributed pattern. And as you can see, we don't. You can see there are some points of light that are more illuminated than others in this stream. Now, we take the same 14 karat gold sample, put it through our nanostar enhanced process, and we come up with the last thing. And as you can see, 14 karat gold with the enhanced nanostar process has even more of those bright reflections, nanostars, than the 14 karat gold one. This is definitely on the road to saying we are able to influence the laser to create more nanostars. Now let's take a look at the video microscope up close, now that we've seen it with the naked eye, to see what these things look like. When we look at it through the laser microscope, we can definitely see the difference between the three samples. We can see the similar pattern in the 20 nanometer one, where the reflected light size is similar. And then in the 14 karat one, we can see it's starting to break out of the box. There are just some of these reflections are just a little bit greater than the other reflections. And then when we look at the nanostar seeded one, we see that a great many of these reflections are much larger than the other reflections. So that shows that we have changed the particles in the one sample. We've created probably more nanostars. So what do you think? Do you think we have nanostars in there? I think we do. I think in our final sample, where we seeded it for nanostars and tweaked the conditions, I think we have a ton of nanostars in there. So what do I think about these gold nanostars? I think they're going to be a tremendous increase in the effectiveness of our nanoparticle solutions, if not gold, and perhaps other metals, if it's possible to create a significant number of nanostars with them as well. With the gold trick, we're using silver, so I don't know how this would work with other metals, but certainly worth investigating. At the very least, it gives us another magnitude of gold, which is probably one of the most sought-after nanoparticles these days for people taking because of its intense mental boost that it gives you. Now, we know plasma arc gold is superior to low-volt electrolysis gold, and we've already done numerous tests with people, and I know the 5-nanometer laser gold, which has already the 10 to 20% nanostars in there, is also a boost over the plasma arc gold. And now, if we make a product now that has 40 or 50% or more nanostar, gold nanostars in there, well, who knows what kind of gold boost effect that we're going to get with our limitless quality. First, I have to do some more testing. This was just the first batch of the stuff. I'd like to try and make it without the sodium citrate and see if I can still just put the silver in there, if I can still create as many nanostars. And I'd like to experiment with different settings see if I can create more or less of them. So it's kind of more research that has to get done there before I'm even going to get near the point where I'm starting to dole this out for testing. Thank you, Wizards, for coming along on the Nanostar ride. I will speak to all of you later.